been asked to stand up.
Final for the boys, 4x800 meters. Calabar, Port Antonio, Belfield, Stets, Jamaica College, Edwin Allen, St. Mary's College, Kingston College, Alphonsus Davis, Tatius Golding, and Magaty are the teams here for the boys 4x800 meter final. Jamaica College with a time of 7 minutes 40.78 to win this event last year. We're here once again. So it is Calabar who have jumped out to an early lead. And a lot of jostling going on. JC now in front ahead of Belfield. KC, they're also ranging up. It will be interesting to see how these young athletes deal with the conditions here. Still raining, maybe not as heavily, but certainly it's wet out there. And a lot of precaution, you think, rather caution, that will have to be taken by these athletes. So, second lap now in this opening leg for the boys 4x800 meters. It's at Jamaica College top with the Kingston College. JC winners of this event last year ahead of Stets and Calabar. All three teams back this year once again, but separating themselves from the pack are JC and Kingston College. Calabar, they lead the chasing pack at the moment. So as conditions get a little bit misty here, it is Kingston College just ahead of Jamaica College, the defending champions for the event. So as the rain pours, Casey pouring on the speed here as they look to make the first changeover to this second leg. So it's Kingston College and followed by Jamaica College. Belfield back there in third, but KC, they have now moved ahead of Jamaica College, who are staying within touching distance. Is JC, he's ranging up quite nicely. They're both teams looking quite easy at this point in time. Also moving up well is Tasia Scolding. And Belfield also back there. Stets in that hunting, chasing pack along with Calabar. Magaty also in that chasing pack. But up top, it's still JC and KC.
Jermaine, with one lap to go on the second leg, is it safe to say it's a two-horse race?
Well, it's shaping up to be that way for sure. Let's see what the others will have to offer a bit later on in the event. Magaty, they boast a good team. Stets, they're a bit back in the pack, but they'll have a lot of work to do for sure to catch JC and the KC, as JC now turns on the afterburners. Just about 200 meters to go on this second leg. JC now really opening up a nice lead. KC struggling here as JC moves away from the field. So JC, an outstanding second leg here for them. And my, you think that with this lead it will take some catching for JC to be overhauled. This is the third leg now, and it is still JC who are opening up that lead. And I tell you, there's a lot going on in the pack as Kingston College, and they have been surpassed as well. Tatius Golding there, but way up top it is Jamaica College. So a lot of work to do for the chasing pack. KC, they were up right there earlier, but have fallen off the pace. As the JC doing all the work up top, and a dominating performance thus far for Jamaica College as they look to retain their title from last year. one lap to go on this third leg. I tell you, Jamaica College really running away with the event here. 7:40.78, their winning time last year, as Kingston College puts themselves back into second place. Way up top, it is Jamaica College leading about some 70 meters and going away. So it is at the 200 meter mark on this second lap on the third leg. It is Jamaica College. KC though, going to work, but can they catch JC this evening? It will be a Herculean task for them to do so. But it is Jamaica College powering home and looking to hand over first. That they've led from pretty much from start to finish. And what a strong run by Jamaica College. This one is Kamaria Bygrave. Didn't win other corporate championships and certainly has been looking good. Their top 800 meter man, Kamaria Bygrave, or JC. And at this point, you'll think it's all over bar the shouting. And JC boasting an outstanding quartet. They say when it rains, it pours, and certainly JC pouring on the pressure here on the rest of the field to catch them. And you think at this point, there's no catching JC with Kamaria Bygrave here. So, approaching the bell lap, if you will. It is JC looking comfortable, looking impressive. Bygrave, second lap now for him on this final leg. My, JC really and truly decimating this field. And you think, barring any eventualities, Bygrave will carry home JC. So, let's see what kind of time JC will lay down here and the Gibson McCook relays with this impressive performance. Just about 210 meters to go. And JC, you may wonder, why are they the only team in the shot at the moment? It's because they're that far ahead. And coming into the picture now is Kingston College, distant second. But JC with Bygrave on anchor. A strong performance from them. As he takes Jamaica College home to victory, and they are well and truly on their way to retaining the title they won last year. 7:45.83 for JC, not quite dipping, beating the time they ran last year of 7:40.78 as KC comes across for a second. I tell you, a lot of drama going on there for the chasing pack. As the JC quartet celebrate, Calabar taking third, and Allen maybe for fourth. But JC dominant all the way throughout. There they are, celebrating in the rain. What a nice feeling that should be. Bygrave and company putting on quite a show here for the spectators.
So, Neville, with your permission, I'll read the definition from dictionary.com.
Of a drizzle, I bet. Drizzle.
To rain gently and steadily in fine drops.
You're right. Well, I actually said it. I said it's a light rain, a drizzle. But that's what I was told.
But apparently, to determine if it's a drizzle, you have to work at the Met service.
Or there might be how light is light.
Once it becomes subjective, then I think we have to...